When the headache started last year, Johannes Struhenberg initially didn't think much of it, but they kept getting worse, and then came the nausea.
I went to a doctor at our walk-in clinic, and he said, oh, it's definitely not a brain tumor, it's probably just nervousness.
This couldn't have been more off the mark. As her symptoms persisted and worsened, Johanna was sent to Sunnybrook for emergency care. She recalls what she was told.
You're going to have brain surgery because I saw something that was pressuring your brain.
Johanna had a 4-centimeter cancerous tumor removed from her brain and then needed radiation.
Walking improvements or no improvements?
I think improvements, yeah.
Dr. Arjun Sehgal says Sunnybrook is one of the few centers in the province that treats brain tumors. While they can happen at any age, aggressive tumors in patients Johanna's age are more unusual. He says the decision to use radiation in younger patients is a careful one.
Because you want to delay the late side effects as long as we can. And those side effects are things that, you know, really difficulty with thinking, the IQ level drops. And it can have some functioning in terms of some deleterious effects in terms of really making it hard to get through school.
Fortunately, he says Sunnybrook has very sophisticated technology to help shape the radiation and help avoid the critical areas of the brain that control IQ, thinking, and long-term memory. And because of the location of Johanna's tumor, they were able to do so. Sunnybrook's full social work team also helps younger patients rehabilitate and reintegrate into everyday living, something Johanna says was critical at her age.
You're just wanting to start your life kind of thing, and then when you suddenly get this throwback of having cancer, it's like, okay, I need to replan my life now.
Part of that plan means she's back at work part-time and hoping to one day attend college, thanks to great care and the support of her family. With Sunnyview, I'm Monica Mattis.